Welcome to our Piping Engineering YouTube channel. We are pleased to provide you piping educational videos. We offer you a great way to support our channel. With our membership packages, you can grow with us and benefit from many special benefits. Before starting the video, be sure to click the subscribe button on below. I would like to express my deep gratitude to our subscribers who became members to help our channel. In this video, we'll learn step by step how to calculate pipe in the pipe spool with easy and fast method. Let's start our education video. We prepared this video according to 6-inch pipe spool. This pipeline consists of 190-degree elbow, 145-degree elbow, 1 equal T, 3 weld neck flanges and 2 pipe sections of different lengths. Let's calculate yellow color pipe's length in this pipeline. As you can see, in this pipeline, the distances from the center of the 90-degree elbow to the center of the equal T and from the center of the equal T to the center of the 45-degree elbow and also from the center of the 45-degree elbow to the face of the weld neck flange are given. If we know the equal T center to end dimension here, we can easily calculate and find the other dimensions ourselves. Also, you can see that all the pipe fittings in this pipeline are fit up together with a 3mm welding gap. Let's look at the equal T dimension chart. Nominal pipe size of equal T's are shown in the first column. The outside diameter of equal T's is shown in the second column. The center-to-end dimensions of equal T's are shown in the third column. This dimension belongs both sides of the equal T. And the length of the equal T is shown on the last column. In our example, we will look at row with nominal pipe size 6. The 6-inch equal T outside diameter 168.3mm shown. And the 6-inch equal T center to end dimension 143mm shown. We will write this 143mm measurement in our pipeline. We know from our previous videos that we use this formula to find the length of the any elbows. Elbow length is equals tangents in bracket elbow degree divided by 2 multiply 38.1 multiply nominal pipe size of elbow. Let's calculate 6-inch 90-degree elbow length with this formula. 6-inch 90-degree elbow length will be equals tangents in bracket 90-degree divided by 2 multiply 38.1 multiply 6. Using the calculator, we find that the tangents 90 divided by 2 multiply 38.1 multiply 6 will be equals 229. So, we calculated and found that the length of the 6-inch 90-degree elbow in our example will be equals 229mm. We will write this 229mm measurement in our pipeline also. Also, during fit-up there should be a gap of about 3mm between the pipe and 90-degree elbow and between the pipe and equal T to be welded. Having this gap is for better root welding. We should take these gaps into account when calculating the length of the yellow color pipe section. If we subtract the length of the 90-degree elbow, equal T center to end dimension and the gaps for welding from this total length, we can easily find the length of the first yellow color pipe section. Pipe length will be equals the total length 978 minus 6-inch 90-degree elbow length 229 minus 6-inch equal T center to end dimension 143 and minus 2 times 3mm gap for welding. At last, we calculate and found one of the first yellow color pipe length will be equals 600mm. With the same method we will calculate second yellow color pipe length. Let's calculate 6-inch 45-degree elbow length with above formula. 6-inch 45-degree elbow length will be equals tangents in bracket 45-degree divided by 2 multiply 38.1 multiply 6. Using the calculator, we find that the tangents 45 divided by 2 multiply 38.1 multiply 6 will be equals 95. So, we calculated and found that the length of the 6-inch 45-degree elbow in our example will be equals 95 millimeters. We will write this 95mm measurement in our pipeline also. Also, during fit-up there should be a gap of about 3mm between the pipe and 45-degree elbow and between the pipe and equal T to be welded. We should take these gaps into account when calculating the length of the yellow color pipe section. If we subtract the length of the 45-degree elbow, equal T center to end dimension and the 3mm gaps from this total length, we can easily find the length of the second yellow color pipe section. Pipe length will be equals, the total length 644, minus 6-inch 45-degree elbow length 95, minus 6-inch equal T center to end dimension 143 and minus 2 times 3mm gap for welding. At last, we calculate and found one of the second yellow color pipe length will be equals 400 millimeters. Also, from this total length 187 millimeters subtract 45 degree elbow length and 3 millimeter gap, we can easily calculate 6 inch weld neck flange length. The weld neck flange length will be equals the total length 187 minus 95 minus 3. At last, we calculate and found 6-inch weld neck flange length will be equals 89 millimeters. I will put the link to the videos about elbows in the description section below, you can enter and watch. That's a wrap for today's educational video. Graduation cap, if you found our content valuable, please like and subscribe to our channel. Your support helps us create more great content for you. We're very happy to embark on this educational journey with you. Thank you for visiting and watching the Piping Engineering YouTube channel.